matters to be determined at this meeting, and if so, to declare it and state the nature of such interest. May I remind you that you should state the item number and title and nature of the interest in question. Any disclosures of interest?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd like to declare an interest in notice of motion number 6 supporting victims of...
Councillor, could you start, please?
I'd like to declare an interest in the notice of motion number 6 supporting victims of domestic abuse. As chair and fundraiser of the Friends of Freedom programme, which is a domestic abuse support group.
Thank you, Councillor. No other announcements? Okay. Moving on to Mayor's announcements. I have been notified of the following apologies: Chris Garuba, Matt Daniel, and John Hale. Is there any other?
Two more, Mr. Mayor. Can't proceed with one. Can't proceed with
that. Thank you. Item two, I have the following announcements to make. I would like all councillors to know the new procedures which we approved by council on the 14th December 2015. Copies have been made available to you. Before we take the council any further, can I just have my chaplain to say prayers, please?
Ladies and gentlemen, let us pray. We thank you for the privilege of serving you and meeting together this evening. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the privilege of decision making that has been given to everyone here. For those who have been elected to serve your people in this borough and to fulfil their responsibilities of leadership. Sometimes that position comes with difficulty, and we do come before you this evening in need of your wisdom. Meet everyone this evening, Lord God, and give everyone here your grace, humility, and the capacity to listen to each other respectfully and diligently. We pray for your skill and imagination as those called to serve hold in their minds and their hearts the different needs that lead to wise decision making. This evening we thank you, Heavenly Father, for the responsibilities that some have fulfilled for many years. We ask you to bless Pat Williams, who has served the Queen and your people for 29 years. As she leaves this work behind, bless her, we pray, and give her a time of rest and enjoyment. Thank you for all she has given and all that she has given up in order to serve here. We thank you too for the Mayor, Councillor Les Rowlands, as he completes his year in office. May his commitment to the three nominated charities leave a mark and make a difference. We pray that the Mayor's commitment to the elderly, the isolated, and those who've been helped by both the Air Ambulance and Clatterbridge will prove fruitful. As he prepares to leave this office, bless him, Heavenly Father, and give him a thankful heart for all that he has been blessed by. May your spirit be present here, and may your grace, righteousness, and integrity be reflected in all discussions this evening. Give to everyone here wisdom, understanding, and that all may live in peace and truth and serve you justly. Amen.
I'd just like to say thank you to my chaplain, Jackie Wise, for supporting us here through the year. Steve Diblock, 14 years. John Salter, 14 years. And an absolute special mention to Pat Williams, 29 years. Pat, that's a lifetime of dedication and work that you've given to this borough. And I want to thank you personally on behalf of everybody here for those 29 years and all those other councillors. Pat, can you come down, because I want to give you some flowers, please.
The way sure I speak on behalf of every member of the council. A big, big thank you to you for that. And also, I think the money that you've raised for your three charities, the Clatterbridge League of Friends, North West Air Ambulance, and the Alzheimer's Society, I think that's been fantastic as well. So I think you can be proud of the year that you've had. I know you'll take away some fantastic memories. But I was going to say, as well as joining you and congratulating all of the councillors, particularly Pat, who has given fantastic service to the borough, can I thank both you and the mayoress for an absolutely superb year. And I think you can be really proud of the service you've given to the borough as our first citizen. So thanks very much.
achieve all those things you haven't yet done, 2 months to get to every place you haven't yet reached, and I hope that you're successful in that. But I know mayors have always targets, they want things they want to do, but as time goes on, they begin to think, I'm getting there, and I want to leave a legacy for my successor, and a good view of what the council has achieved, and what the public do, and what the public do in rural voluntary organisations. Mr Mayor, I'd like to thank you for your courtesy throughout the year, for your tact as well, and also, I think, what a very approachable manner. I was going to try and find words that describe the strength of personality, and I think gravitas is what you have, but it is a warmth and approachability that comes with that, that has come in your term of office. I'm grateful for the manner in which you have approached all the events and dealt with council throughout the year, and I'm also grateful for what you said about retiring members of all parties. And you'll forgive me if I also briefly touch on the contribution of Councillor Williams. I have somewhere in my filing system a picture of Councillor Pat Williams in Hoylake Town Hall. On this particular occasion, Pat was visiting the staff toilets in Hoylake Town Hall, and she was surprised to discover that the ladies' facilities in Hoylake Town Hall had a gentleman's facility, a gentleman's urinal. I don't know what I've done with that picture, but it reminds me of how Pat always wanted to find out what really goes on around the borough and how our staff and facilities are provided. And it's a fond memory, actually. But it's a good wish to
make. I think we could make the best of that.
Calling for the Seacombe ferry to remain in use.
there any issues in any accuracy in respect of any of these minutes? All those in favour, please clearly indicate. Any votes against? Any abstentions? Okay, they're clearly carried. Moving on to item 6, leaders, executive members and chairs reports. Item 6 on page 1 to 28 of the agenda contains the reports of leaders, cabinet members and policy and performance committee chairs. The council is invited to receive the notice of these reports. Placed on your chairs this evening, councillors, there were the new changes that's come to the council. I just wanted to point out that these are not set in stone. We are trying this new format out. If it needs tweaking, we will come back and revisit and have a look at it. But the procedures have been changed, so obviously those indications were put on your chairs this evening due to notice of provisions. Okay. All questions must be compliant to the content of the report. Questioners, please ensure that the question is no longer than 2 minutes. Total number of questions on any one report will not normally exceed more than 5 minutes. Responses to the question will be reserved to the conclusion of all questions on all reports. Now, are there any questions which councillors wish to ask in respect of the leaders, executive members and chairs report? There will be an allocation of, maximum 30 minutes for questions and answers to the leaders, cabinet members and policy performance committee chairs, which can be asked in any order. Any questions? Councillor Blakely.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I have 5 questions, 4 to cabinet members and 1 to a chairperson of the committee. I'll start with the chairperson for the people of family and well-being. In 3.7, which talks about the scrutiny workshop, does the chairperson believe that by time limiting the matters before the families and well-being scrutiny workshop and limiting questions and debate allowed for full and proper scrutiny of the proposals before us? I have a question to leader of the council. Given that leader of the council states as the number one priority in his 2020 vision is protecting the most vulnerable, does he now agree with me and service users that the proposal to close care for court, a facility that provides professional and compassionate care, is ill-conceived and removes choice from people, choice that he professes he wants to give them? I have a question for the portfolio holder for housing and communities on good quality housing. Given the housing developers are lining up tranches of green belts, land ready for development but will publish its local plan, when will the cabinet member be able to publish the council's housing needs analysis? A question to the portfolio holder for central and support services, section 1 asset management. Can the cabinet member, regarding Foxhill School, can the cabinet member provide a timetable and methodology for the disposal of the former Foxhill School site? And finally, a question to the portfolio holder for transport technology strategy and infrastructure. Liverpool City Region Transport Plan for Growth Forward Plan. Can the Cabinet Member tell Council if the long-awaited, much-needed town with a lane railway station is included within the 19 scheme put forward for consideration in the City Region Assessment Process? Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Councillor Blake. Can we have those answers now, please?
Discussion
Right, in terms of housing needs analysis, very difficult thing to answer, partly, but the contributing stats is, you know that I've put forward that we will build 3,500 new properties over the next 5 years, part of the 2020 plan. The housing needs analysis becomes, takes over in some ways, because realistically what the government is saying is, well, you need to make or build 680 properties per year, and that's in the brownfield. Now, over the next 5 years, I think we can do that, quite honestly. But nevertheless, it doesn't stop there, and we've got to look, and the local development plan, when it's published very shortly, should be out hopefully by the end of this year, before, for the end of this year, so it's got to be in and ready for 2017. So the answer to that is quite honestly, because I mean, if there's present moment in time, that's fine. Future, we need to look at other things as well.
Thank you, George.
Councillor Jones.
I'd be happy to provide you with a written report. That's good.
Thank you.
Councillor Jones. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Likewise, I'll give you a motion.
What's the do you not know how I'm going to do another?
I'll give you a motion.
I don't think council members should be aware of the portfolio, Mr. Mayor.
Councillor.
The short answer to your question, Chris, is no, I don't believe it will remove choice because...
rubbish! Absolute rubbish!
Because the issue here, Mr. Mayor, and I'll elaborate on this later on in the debate, is we have all of our funding for the respite care toilet in a single building, and a one-size-fits-all model is right for some people, it's not right for all people, and
how about majority?
Speak
to the families.
Speak
to us and ask.
Ask the 120 families what they want.
Speak to the families. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Just remind the public that this is a council meeting. You need to observe.
Can you save us?
A public meeting. Yeah, the council must be allowed to vote.
Sorry, I'm just going to finish up by saying the fact is, Mr. Mayor, we have a number of disabled people and their carers who are saying they want other choices.
How many? Give us a percentage, please. Give us some numbers. Anyone can say that.
Can you please allow the councillor to answer the question?
So, Mr. Mayor, can't answer. This is point. This is not about a budget cut, this is about great choice.
About choice, crap! Why was it brought up in the budget meeting?
You're going to offer me an
absolute disgrace.
We will offer
absolute disgrace to Labour.
A range of choices.
It's a disgrace. How you can sleep at night, fella? You and your party.
Let's vote for Labour.
We can get our normal.
Absolute disgrace.
Is
issue about the 2020 pledges, these were agreed, the 2020 pledges and the work plan was agreed by every member of council in July of last year. And therefore, I'm working on the basis that we're all signed up to those pledges, and as a council, we will work as hard as we can over the next 5 years to deliver those pledges. It's my commitment to council and to the people of Wirral that we will focus all of our energies on delivering those 2020 pledges. And officers and members who hear me speak about this will, I'm sure, agree that I am absolutely focused on outcomes for the people of Wirral and improving those outcomes, whether that be in improving the condition of vulnerable people, getting more businesses, more investments, and more jobs into the borough, and improving our environment, street scene. And for me, those are the issues that I'm concerned about, and those are the issues that I'll be focusing on. So, just to make it absolutely clear, this is the 20 pledges are something that I believe that all of us in this chamber have a role to play in delivering. And on the peer review, I think the reality is I won't apologise for it only just being published, because there's been a the team who did the peer review has actually taken quite a bit of time to produce the final report. There were a number of factual inaccuracies that needed to be corrected. There was a various kind of iterations, and literally in the last few weeks we've agreed, or they've agreed, the final version. And I made a commitment to the start of the, before we had the peer review, that I would publish the final report once that's been agreed. It's been agreed within the last few weeks, and it's now been published on our website. There is an action plan to go with the peer review report, which says what we're doing in response to each of the recommendations. I understand that the document looking at Wirral is going to the scrutiny committee. The peer review report. It's going to the peer review report is going to the scrutiny committee next week, and there'll be ample opportunity, I'm sure, for comments to be made on that report, and if necessary, for any input to come back to cabinet. So I don't apologise for the length of time it's taken. It wasn't anything that we were responsible for. And just to reiterate, Mr. Mayor, you know, I think the peer review report was a fair assessment. They were very complimentary of the progress we've made in the last 3 years, but clearly more work to be done. And I think we've got some interesting plans around transformation and the other agenda. So that's it. Thanks, Mr.
Thank you, Councillor Davis. Councillor Williams.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. My question is for Councillor Adrian Jones regarding health, safety and resilience. You suggest the severe weather conditions are more likely threat than terrorist activities, Adrian. How does this fit in to the need for a large reserve of money? And why does cash back to Wirral then money to local authorities?
Criticised us in the past and used the term cash strapped and said we
as we do. And although it's been condemned by the other side, they know very well that they would probably be doing the same, and they know very well that it would be frankly financially neglect to fail to earn the money that we do earn by our short-term loans. They know very well that to fail to get that money in for this borough would be a frightful neglect. It's a shocking fact that they criticise us for in fact making investments and face money, and it should be a shame.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I have just one question to the Cabinet Member for Transport, Technology, Strategy and Infrastructure. Members may recall that December Council, I asked the Cabinet Member a question about outstanding street lamp affairs and was told that they would be prioritised. This was followed by a press release in February, Council stepping up street light repairs, promising that they would be caught up by the end of April. Today, another press release claiming on target to meet street light repair deadline, accompanied by a charming photograph of a cabinet member fixing a sticker to a lamp in his own ward, reading, "This street light has been repaired by Wirral Council, March 2016. So, Mr. Mayor, will the cabinet member explain to council and to Wirral residents how it has been acceptable, despite his prioritisation, for so many of them to have been left in the dark throughout the winter months?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I have been given that last notice from another member of the professional along civil lines, so I'll be, as a go council, I'll reserve a detailed response until that question has been asked. But I'd like to point out every single penny that's been taken out of the service of the council, because the cuts by your government, you've not once been condemned this, or you've not once done for the people who are not treated elected, you should be ashamed.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I submitted three questions. One was based on the Cabinet report of Councillor David Jones and read as follows. On page 7, reference is made to the imminent fine offer from Maurice Holmes for the Landtaker Lane. In discussions leading to the final offer, what are the timescales envisaged for the arrival of the capital receipt and the submission of a planning application? I've submitted two questions to Council Whittingham, Mr. Mayor, both of which you gave notice. In Council Whittingham's report, based on my reading, the actual repair of existing lights is not mentioned. My question is, as of 9th March, the Council's website was displaying the list of lights scheduled to be repaired during February. How many of those listed were repaired? How many were awaiting repairs at 9th March? And is it the intention to replace the February list with an updated list of those identified as needing repair? And my third question, Mr. Mayor, and Councillor Whittingham as well. On page 22, reference is made to the pipeline of schemes put forward for consideration for Liverpool City Region. I trust the Cabinet Member will appreciate that. Members will wish to know what Wirral is seeking to secure, and members will need to know of potential schemes with impacts in their wards or the wider community. Therefore, can the Council receive details of the schemes submitted and a list of those that were considered but not put forward? Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Councillor Whittingham.